Hey metalheads, let's talk about metal, and today I'm so happy because there's a new Dream Theater song called Night Terror, and it just leaked, and I'm just going to listen to that right now. It's the premiere, it's the return of Mike Portnoy. I've been waiting for that 15 years. Let's fucking go! Okay, Night Terror, what a nice song title to come back after Black Clouds that I loved so much. Oh, nice. Welcome back, Mike! Yeah! The production. It sounds fantastic, the drum sound, the guitar, oh my god, John Petrucci, his new signature guitar. Holy hell! Now that's Dream Theater! It warms my heart so much! John Mayong. As morning light shines on. What a riff. That drum part is tasty. Jordan. I think James LeBrie sounds pretty good. They are so good at that. Damn, Mike! On the Love that moody drum part. Unleash the beast! That spooky sound. Nice punch, Mike. Great feel. So tasty. I think it will be John's turn. Mike, man. Flight of the Bumblebee. Liquid tension experiment, anyone? Transition. Pure beauty. Instrumental break. Yes! They are really back in full force now. Oh my god. 10 minutes went so fast. Wow. What a song. I've been waiting for Mike Portnoy to come back in the band for so long. I think the songwriting with Mike is not the same, and we can see that on this new song. Almost all the great elements of Dream Theater were back in the mix, and the sound of this production, the sound of the drums is incredible. It's like the best sound you can get of a prog metal band. Damn, that was sounding good. Yes! The song is gong sealed now. Wow! I'm so glad. Fuck! Everything was there. James LaBrie was sounding great. The chorus was really catchy, but dark at the same time. It's like they took where they left when Mike left. Because the last album, Black Cloud Silver Lining, was released in 2009. And to me, it was one of the best Dream Theater album ever. I think this album was a lot underrated. The Count of Tuscany, Nightmare 2, Remember, The Best of Times, The Shattered Fortress, come on, Rite of Passage. There's so many great songs on that fucking album. And now to see them back together with a song that sounds a lot like that album. It's very dark. And John Petrucci, his guitar sound on this one. The solo section. Let's talk about a little bit about that solo section that was completely astonishing. Not like the album, obviously. It was just everything you will want from them. You got that Flight of the Bumblebee-like part that sounds like Liquid Tension Experiment. And you have that really nice keyboard haunting solo by Jordan Rudess. You have also the great solo with the sound of the first solo of John Petrucci was so nice. I don't know the effect he was showcasing there, but the sound of his guitar was a little bit different than we usually hear. Maybe it's new because of his new signature guitar, but it sounded amazing. And the switch, the transition to the soulful solo by John was just, man, unmatchable. Oh my god, it's hard to describe how great I was feeling when that switch happened. It was wow. Just those kind of melodic part that only Petrucci does, and it's so efficient, it connects with your heart deeply right away. Can't wait to hear that full album. I'm not sure if it will be the best song, but that 10 minutes went so fast. I went, wow, so excited. And Mike Portnoy, man, your drumming on this freaking song is amazing. Like, all the tricks in the bag were there, the tricks that we know Mike for. He just complements every single guitar and keyboard part so well, and even his back when his back vocals, and that was sounding really good with James. Man, that album, when they will release that album. Parasomnia will be released on February 7th via Inside Out Music. Okay, so we have to wait until the beginning of 2025, it will be so nice to have a full length of Dream Theater. And I like the album they put out after Mike was gone. Not The Astonishing. I think that album has like three songs that were good. Gift of Music and two other one. The self-titled album is not bad at all. It's like the long song Illumination Theory. I think it was pretty good. The Big Picture. There was the Behind the Veil was good too. But my favorite one is the album with Breaking All Illusions. And I think the songwriting on that an unexpected there's some really, really good song. Lost Not Forgotten is incredible. Breaking All Illusion, one of my top Dream Theater song ever. But you still feel Mike Portnoy on that album, even if it's Mike Mangini. Not necessarily on drums, but more on how the songwriting was done. You still feel, I'm pretty sure Mike contributed to some of those songs. Maybe I'm wrong. If someone knows about if Mike was involved in the songwriting of some of the songs on A Dramatic Turn of Heaven, that's the name of the album. Not an Unexpected. That is The Hobbit, the first. An Unexpected Journey. What do you think about this comeback song by Dream Theater? What do you think about the return of Mike Portnoy? Do you think he sounded great like I think? I think it's a masterpiece, that song. Seriously? Very high quality Dream Theater to me. So, I will let you on this. Thanks for being part of this journey with me. If you're new to the channel, let's stick a little bit together. You can subscribe if you want to follow more closely, and drop a like if you like that song, and I'll see you in the next one, like always. Yes, such an exciting time to be a fan of Dream Theater and prog music in general. Cheers, guys.